Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I hope you are all doing fine. Today we'll start a new way of teaching and learning. This can be done from the comforts of your homes, wherever you are staying. And this new method is new for you, but it has been in practice in many universities for many years. So we have to get used to it, try it. It has many advantages which we'll see as we progress. Now let's recall what we had done in the last 6 weeks in the classes which we had. Now we had finished the practice problem 1 with solutions. I had given you copies of this. Put it in the Moodle, and we had solved all these questions and similar questions in larger numbers, and some of them came in the quiz 1. Now what are the topics? Let's recall the topics which we had done. The first thing which we did was the fractions. In arithmetic and mathematics, we have 4 basic operations: addition, subtraction are the first 2, the third is multiplication, fourth is division. So we had learned how to do all these 4 things: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, using fractions. Then the next topic which we had learned was the laws of indices. We had paid greater attention to the first law, which enabled us to combine 2 powers, x power m into x power n equal to x power m plus n. The multiplication changes to addition. As you can see here, we are multiplying on the left, on the right we are adding in the indices. We had not done much of second and third law, which we'll be using in the other worksheets. Then what we learned was the 2 term factorization: x power 2 minus a power 2 equal to x minus a into x plus a. Now the power 2 has a name. It is x square minus a square equal to x minus a into x plus a. Whenever we have power 2, we have to look for 2 brackets. If the power is 3, we have to look for 3 brackets. But in this worksheet, we'll be focusing more on this kind of expressions where we have 2 terms and then we'll factorize it. The 2 term factorization is here, and this is a 3 term factorization again with power 2. In the first case, we had just 2 terms. Here we have 3 terms. What is the third term? The third term is this middle term with the x here. And again, since the power is 2, we get 2 brackets like this. And the fifth topic which we did was equation of a straight line in slope intercept form. There are several ways to write the equation of a straight line, and we have chosen one of the ways called as the slope intercept form. Now in this, we learned to identify the slope, the x-intercept and the y-intercept, where the line intercept means to catch, where the line catches the x-axis and the y-axis. We also did special type of lines which are straight up, called as vertical. And then we have the horizontal lines which are not going up, not going down, they are just horizontal. Now for each of these things, 5 topics which I mentioned you, we had done enough practice of questions. Now I'll just repeat one example for you to get familiarized with this long distance way of teaching. You had all done this example in the quiz. Most of you got it correct, and it was also repeated after the quiz. So I'm just going to take one example which you know, so that you get an experience of a familiar question using this new way of technology. Now what is the first type of question which we did? We did in problem 1, multiply out the brackets. Now in multiplying out the brackets, the minimum pairs we need is 2 pairs of brackets. We will not use the word pair, when we say two brackets, we have one bracket here and one bracket here. Now we look at the second example, which is easier than the first example. Now in this example, we have two brackets and the English is multiply out the brackets. Look at the English. It says multiply out the brackets and the question is here. You have two brackets. One is 2x minus 4. The second bracket is 3x plus 5. Now you are multiplying two brackets. Now in mathematics, most people, most books open the left bracket. Please remember, we open only one bracket at a time. Even your fast computers open one bracket at a time. So we have chosen to open the left bracket. See, the right bracket is copied as it is. 3x plus 5, 3x plus 5. What we are opening is the first bracket. The first bracket is 2x minus 4. So we have 2x here, minus 4 here. So we copy the 2x here and the minus 4 here. We do not open the second bracket in the first step, only the first bracket. The second bracket is verbatim copied. Copied exactly. Just keep a finger on it and copy it without making any mistakes. Now we have to, this is the first step, you open the first bracket. Now in the second step, we have to open the second bracket. Now how do you open the second bracket? Now just look at 2x into 3x plus 5. This we'll look after finishing the first. 2x into 3x is 6x square. Copy the plus. 2x into plus 5 is 10x. Now we have opened the first bracket. In the first step, in the second step, you open this part of the bracket. This part of the first step. Now take the minus 4 into 3x, you get minus 12x. Minus 4 into plus 5 is minus 20, because minus into plus is minus. Now we have four terms in the second step. Two of them come from opening this bracket and two of them come from opening this bracket. So total four terms. But how many types are there? This x power 2, which has a name, x square, is alone. This number minus 20 is alone. There is no other number in this step, only minus 20. So you copy the 6x square, copy the minus 20. Nothing has to be done on that. But the x term, you have plus 10x here and minus 12x here. You are subtracting plus 10 minus 12. 10 minus 12 is minus 2. So write minus 2x here. So your last step is 6x square minus 2x minus 20. And this is the end of your answer. Nothing more has to be done and can be done. You are given two brackets. You open the brackets. We call it multiply out the brackets. Your final answer will be free from brackets. We cannot combine this. The reason is, here the power is 2, here the power is 1, here there is no power, it's only a number. So we cannot mix things. 2 pens plus 1 pencil is 2 pens and 1 pencil only. You cannot say 3. It is 2 pens and 1 pencil. So this is your answer. Do not combine further. Stop here. Now just look here. You stop. Start with the two brackets and end without brackets after you finish the answer. We'll do more examples shortly. Thank you.